Hey everybody, welcome to my YouTube video. I know my podcasts are probably the most boring kind of video for me to make, but it's also the easiest, I think, for me. I'm wearing my retainer, so I probably sound kind of slurry. This is quite the fear facer for me, because I normally don't record in my room at all, so this is a first. But everyone's sleeping, hopefully I'm not disturbing them, but basically, I just kind of wanted to talk about information that I've learned off or found on YouTube, because I honestly kind of want to complain where I found videos where I found a video I was about, you know, how to leash train your dog. So I was like, oh, this seems like it'll be great. And in the video, someone was suggesting a prong collar. Now, I'm not making this to be all bossy or tell people what to do, and I don't think that's a problem since no one will probably watch this, but more just to state my opinion, and that's that it's not really worth it. Like, it's like not rewarding your dog for a trick. It's like, it feels pretty pointless, and it can, in your mind, you might think, well, if the dog has a treat for the trick, then it'll, you know, get spoiled, but it feels like that's pretty pointless. So just sort of patience, I think, is the main thing with any animal, and with any animal situation, is to take the time and take the money. If you're gonna get a pet, you gotta be willing to put in the effort and put in the time, and not to jump to the easiest, quickest solution, or what the internet says is the easiest, quickest solution, because in all honesty, what I've heard happens is that the animal basically gets used to pulling on the prong collar as well, and it still pulls, it's just less good for the animal. And it might help better to actually put in positive reinforcement training, where you basically heel train by luring with a treat, and it'll take a long time probably, but at least you aren't going to be wasting time using a method that might not even help. And it probably won't help actually at all. And in a situation where it would help, it wouldn't be worth it, because you are causing pain to the animal. You might be pretty sure in your mind that you're not, but it's basically spikes, and those are gonna hurt even an animal with maybe tougher, stronger necks like dogs. Even if you have it on a loose setting, your loose setting wall, setting works, I guess. Even if it's loose, even if it's the right kind, if it spikes and the animal pulls on spikes, those are gonna poke its neck. That's how it works, you know? At least, you know, that's how I see it. So, honestly, I think the main thing is just, it upsets me, because that's not the worst that there is on YouTube for teaching people about things that aren't the best for animals. It's not really the worst of it at all. There's stuff out there that's actually scary, like, yeah, it's pretty bad. People yelling at a horse, or, well, someone yelling at a horse. I've only seen a certain instance of that, and just different things that I'm really not comfortable with animals. It's really not how you, it's really not training at that point, it feels like. It feels like it's more like, I don't know if bribe is the right word. It's manipulating. It's not training, it's manipulating. It's the most you're gonna have an animal that is scared enough of getting poked that it feels. And that's probably not even something that will happen. So, unpopular opinion, obviously, if you look at the YouTube statistics. But I don't know. I figured I might try and make something constructive out of something that bothered me. I mean, it's about YouTube, so why not make a video for YouTube from it, you know? But, yeah. It's, I don't know. I guess the main thing is, this is more just for my sake of having fun and talking about something, because I don't think really this information is gonna reach anyone who would need it, and if it did reach someone who needed it, they wouldn't necessarily be someone who was willing to change their mind. So, yeah, I guess that's that, and yeah. Thank you so much for watching. I had fun. I hope you did. And if you enjoyed it, please like. Thank you. Bye.